Oh, lucky you. You've just tuned into the best show on Spreaker. And I wouldn't say that if it wasn't true. We are moments away from getting our dork on the Chris Topp Program.
The Chris Topp Program.
Hi, I'm Chris Topp. First off, I want to thank you for tuning into the Chris Topp Program. While I try my best to keep the show as rated PG-13 as possible, sometimes things slip out, or sometimes things happen, and that's just the way live radio goes. And because this is the internet, the FCC isn't around to tell me what I can and can't do. So because of the occasional slip-up or the guest that might get out of hand, you really need to be 18 or older to listen. If you happen to be under 18, please make sure you get your parents' permission.
Get ready to lose moments of your life you'll never get back.
Take it for the time.
Sit back, relax, and try not to get too irritated.
Broadcasting live to at least three people.
My head just went numb.
That's just the intoxicating aroma of Chris Topp filling your ears.
Hey, can I sue for that?
Welcome to the Chris Topp Program.
The Chris Topp what?
The Chris Topp Program.
And I am the one and only Chris Topp, broadcasting live from my lavish studio apartment here in sunny Clarksville, Tennessee, with an ocean view. And I played my old intro. I was trying to go retro a little bit, but you know what I forgot? I forgot the drum line. And that kind of irritates me a little bit because I don't know. See, I did that for like a year. How could I? Let me see if I can find it real quick, because now I'm irritated at myself. And that happens a lot. It really does. I get irritated at myself a lot. I really, really do. But let me see if I can pull up. Oh, there it is. All right, so let's try this again. I'm just going to play the drum. I'm not going to do the whole intro again. That'd be a little much, I think. So we'll just do the drum line. And that's just like in the beginning with the Chris Topp Program. This is what we used to do. Dude, that used to get me pumped. It really, really did. But anyway, I appreciate you being here. I appreciate you listening. And I've got a few things I want to talk about. And this is going to be a quick show today just because, well, you'd feel sorry for me if you knew what time I had to get up. But I'm not even close to being sleepy because I slept really good last night. And I had to get up just stupid early. But I don't have to get up as early again the next day. So I'm thinking if I can just make it through the day tomorrow, I should be fine because I'll get to sleep in the next day. So I'm hoping this works out. I may have to take one of those 5-hour energy shots or a couple of those just to get through. But I'm going to try. And I missed you guys, so I wanted to go ahead and get on and broadcast just for a little while. And you know how I'm always talking about the zombie apocalypse? Well, I found more proof. How much freaking proof do you need? All right, now, when Yasmin Gomes stopped breathing almost immediately after her birth, and she was born in Brazil, the doctor signed her death certificate. So, in most cases, at that point, it would have been over. Now, a nurse requested the baby be taken to the hospital's chapel instead of the morgue. She said that Yasmin was a little angel. Or maybe she should have said, a little zombie. Now, 3 hours later, people think I'm crazy, I know. Maybe I am. The infant's grandmother found the baby girl kicking and breathing when she arrived. I wonder, see, they left out the part probably where the baby reached up and she grabbed the nurse by the neck and she pulled her down and probably ate her heart out. Now, a nurse who attended the birth says, I can assure you the child was dead. Her pupils didn't respond to light. All her signs pointed to the complete absence of life. She was blue all over. Sounds to me like she's really trying to cover it up. I mean, seriously. She was completely dead. Now, an amazed doctor says people can make their own conclusions, but only those who were there know what really happened. In other words, we're doctors, we screwed up. Okay, so we're just going to cover this up. We're going to call it a miracle, is what we're going to do. See, they should have went with a zombie thing, and it probably would have been a whole lot more believable. This is what the world's coming to. All right, Japan's newspaper said Thursday that sales of adult diapers in the rapidly aging nation are on track to outpace those of baby diapers. Japan's largest diaper manufacturer said that that point actually already occurred in 2011. Yeah, so there's more adults in Japan wearing diapers than babies. I don't know if you should go there to try to pick up chicks. I really, really don't know. Okay, Japan has the highest percentage of over 65s in the whole world, with over a fifth of the population a part of that demographic. Now, three of Japan's paper companies are expanding their range of products to keep up with the expected demand. Or maybe they should call it the unexpected demand. I don't know. I'm just throwing that out there because I don't know. And speaking of diapers, I really, really wish I would have thought of this. I really do, because I think this is genius. Now, men, you know what I'm talking about. There's been those times where you go to the bathroom, and I'm talking number one. You go to the bathroom, and you don't get a chance to really shake it like you should. Or maybe you think you shook it enough, but you didn't. And then you put it back in your pants. And then there's that little spot on your pants. Now, if you walk out of the bathroom like that, people are going to automatically know what that is. So you can't do that. So what I've done in the past is I would wash my hands and then just throw a whole bunch of water in my lap. And that way, people just assume that I'm a messy hand washer. Or it's like I had an accident in the sink and not an accident in my pants. Now, I probably could have avoided that had I had this. And I'm not the only one, I know. That's why I'm not ashamed to talk about it. But just check this out. I think it's genius.
Oh, hey, thing starter. I didn't see you there. My name's Ed Daniels, and what I do see is a problem that affects half the population. Male spotting. Whenever a guy pees, there's always that one drop that seems to stick around. So after years of suffering, I finally invented tiny diapers for the tip of your penis. These super absorbent diapers fit snugly onto the tip of any penis. They take care of that extra drip without the bulk of a full-size diaper. I spent 6 months in my workshop perfecting this design. I chose the softest fabric to prevent penis rash. I also created this modified fanny pack that not only stores the tiny diapers, but also acts as the applicator. The carrot represents the penis. But I need your help to start mass production, ThingStarter. Currently, I make them by hand, which takes 4 hours per diaper. But here's the great thing about tiny diapers for the tip of your penis. They aren't just for the tip of your penis. My friends have come up with some great uses that I never even thought about. Use a tiny diaper to stop a leaky faucet. Going for a run? Use a couple tiny diapers on your nipples. They also can catch tears if you're crying.
I'm crying.
And if you're incredibly tiny, use a tiny diaper, like a full-size diaper. Now I'm going to respond to some questions that I constantly have to answer. First, will these work if I want to pee full force into my pants? No, these aren't for you. You should use Depends. Do these handle poop? No, you don't poop out of your penis. You poop out of your butt. Are tiny diapers associated with toxic shock syndrome? Unfortunately, yes. So I need your support to get these into production, ThingStarter, and we've got lots of neat rewards. For $10, you get 10 tiny diapers. For $20, you get 20 tiny diapers. For $30, you get 30 tiny diapers. For $40, you get 40 tiny diapers. And for $50, you get 51 tiny diapers. That's the best deal. Thanks for watching, and please donate. Because remember, the time couldn't be riper for a tiny diaper. Please donate.
The time couldn't be riper for a tiny diaper. For $50, you get 51 diapers. That's the best deal.
Winnie the Pooh is based on psychological problems.
Pooh has an eating disorder.
Piglet suffers from anxiety.
Tigger has ADD.
Rabbit suffers from OCD.
Eeyore battles major depression.
Christopher Robin must be a drug addict if his stuffed animals talk to him.
No beloved childhood characters were harmed in the making of this ringtone. Well, at least not intentionally. Pooh did try to eat Piglet. Tigger couldn't stop shaking Rabbit's hand, which drove him insane. And Eeyore hung himself because he couldn't deal with the fact Christopher Robin was a drug addict.
Listening to the Chris Top program burns more calories than setting a fat kid on fire.
This, my friends, is the Chris Top program. You're absolutely, positively in the right place. And this is a very quick version of the Chris Top program today because, well, I couldn't sleep and I need to go to bed. But I wanted to spend a little time with you guys just because I don't get to do it as much as I used to. So it's kind of nice to be on here broadcasting, even if it's just for a few minutes. Now, if you are a dork, and I know more than likely you are, if you're listening to my show, I want you to go ahead and stand to your feet, because this is the Dork National Anthem. This is the Wabba song, Working on Being Awesome, by my good buddy Belgium Tim. We're going to follow that up with the Wabba Rap by my good buddy Big N. So stand to your feet, place your hand over your heart, and I want you to say this. I'm a dork. I'm hip. But I messed that up. I totally messed that. Well, you know what to say.
Working on being awesome every day. I'm working on being awesome every day. W-O-B. Representing the doors. Dorks of the world unite, y'all. Yeah. Hey, there, everybody, yo, I got something to say. The sky ride over there is Wabba every single day. Okay, what is Wabba eating?
It sounds creepy,
cult thing. Not dude, it's just a little dork singing. Well, W is working, O is only B is being. And A is for awesome, and that's the dork singing. I'm already awesome, but that's okay. Cause Mr. Chris Top is too, but he just doesn't know it. And so are all of you from here on to the on far. And just so you know, life is good and I'm gone.
Okay, so Scooter, if I only get a couple hours of sleep tonight, and then I've got to make it through 8 or 9 hours, what's the best way for me to do that? I mean, how much Red Bull should I drink to get through the day? And that's what I'm asking, because I see that's what I'm going to be facing tomorrow. Because right now I'm wide awake, but when my alarm clock goes off, I'm going to be in trouble. And you know what? I was so lucky I got up this morning. I was incredibly lucky because my phone is possessed. And does anybody else have this problem? Does anybody else have a droid? Does anybody else have a droid? I've got I don't even know what kind of phone this is. It's either possessed or it's faulty. And I'm hoping it's faulty and there's not some demon in my phone, but I will go to text and it'll start pushing letters by itself. And I'll have to like back it up and I'll have to like hit the letters before the phone does. And then send the text really quick. And sometimes I'll be trying to text and it'll just start pushing a bunch of stuff. It'll go to a different screen and then it'll call somebody. It'll call somebody that I haven't talked to in 10 years that I don't want to talk to. And it's like, oh my God, I'm trying to push the button. I'm trying to hang up, but it won't hang up. And then it's like, it rings, and then this person, hey, how you doing? Yeah, I know, I haven't talked to you in forever. I was just kind of wanting to catch up. And then I can't even fake hang up because the phone won't let me. So then I'm stuck in this conversation. Does anybody else's phone do that, or is it just mine? Should I go see a Catholic priest? Should I throw some holy water on it? I need some suggestions because I don't know what to do. And Scooter says I should go with a 12-pack of Mountain Dew. You know, probably if I cut back on that before I went to bed, I would probably be sleeping right now. So that could actually be part of my problem. You know, there's a new survey that's out, and it talks about how people don't like their jobs. And again, why do they have to spend money on this stuff? I mean, that's pretty much common sense, right? The London School of Economics and Political Science has determined work is no fun. Thank you. You uppity British crazy people. Now, researchers surveyed over 10,000 working folks, mostly Britons. The only thing they were... And I'm sure it's just like this in America as well. The only thing the respondents disliked more than work was being sick in bed. And when offered dozens of options, from going to a concert to paying bills, people ranked cleaning the house or waiting in line as preferable to being on the job. Wouldn't it be a better world if everybody just loved their job? Wouldn't it? Now, while generally working a shift outside the standard 9 to 5 was considered more stressful, respondents said working between 6 a.m. and 8 a.m. was less stressful. And I don't even understand that. I have no idea. I don't get that. But whatever. Now, you know, I came across a story that was really confusing to me. And, of course, I'm going to share it with you. Because I want you to be as confused as I am. Now, you know, I'm 41, almost 42. I'll be 42 in a few days, but I'm not yet. And don't forget that. Now, I listen to the younger people sometimes, and when they say fracking, I'm pretty sure I know what that means. Fracking, F-R-A-C-K-I-N-G. And I'm pretty sure you know what that means as well. So I came across this article, and it confused the hell out of me. Here we go. We already knew fracking caused earthquakes. I don't know what they mean by that. Are they being literal? Like, every time I frack, is there an earthquake? I mean, I can't frack as good as I used to. I mean, sometimes I'm just kind of fracked out. So I don't know if my personal fracking could cause an earthquake. Pretty fracked up, if you ask me, because it sucks. It fracking sucks to get old. It really does. But there's a new study that suggests that there could be a larger and much more frequent than we assumed. And we're still talking about fracking. Listen up, mother frackers. All right, Professor Emily Brodsky led a study at a power plant in California. Am I just stupid? Does fracking mean something else? Where workers were injecting around 500 million gallons of water into the ground every month. There was an earthquake about every 11 days. Why would you want to cause an earthquake on purpose? Now, the reason, she says, is the water is priming cracks in the Earth's crust, meaning earthquakes can be triggered by tremors from other earthquakes thousands of miles away. Now, Brodsky says that this doesn't mean we should stop fracking entirely. Well, I wasn't going to frack you if you think I'm going to stop fracking. She just suggests being careful about where and how much we frack. So most environmental activists would probably prefer the first option. So I don't know. I mean, frack it. I'm going to keep fracking, and I'm sure you probably will as well. The only advice I have for you is that if you're going to frack, just make sure you wear fracking protection. You can be the top king of Chris Top for one. Mr. Top. Take it from the top.
Check me out by the wall at the dance. Looking sharp. sharp in my high water sweatpants. I wish I was at home where I could be blogging and watching wrestling. I hang out and play magic cards after school with all the crossing guards, they're cool. Yeah, I believe in magic. I was first in line to buy Halo 3 on Friday night. Your boss one day. Check me out in the back of the class. I'm daydreaming about World of Warcraft. While I write dirty words on my calculator, I'll show you later. Even my mother picks on me. I dress up when I watch Lord of the Rings. Even when I'm home by myself.
That are filled all the way to capacity. Honestly, I enjoy the booty dances. I've got it favorited on YouTube. I like a little wobble wobble, especially when I'm listening to Lynyrd Skynyrd. Free bird! It's almost like a nice booty closes any cultural gaps in society that may exist.
When I die, I'm going to haunt the absolute fuck out of you people.
You can either talk in the crystal program.
I sense a disturbance in the force. The dork side is strong in this one.
Did you hear that? This is madness. We're doomed.
Yoda, I don't think I can go back to Spreaker.
Always with you. It cannot be done.
Well, no, I think I could do it. I just don't know if I'm ready.
You know nothing that I say.
Wait, what? Can you just not talk Yoda for a minute?
You must unlearn what you have learned.
Okay, dude, you totally don't make any sense. If I unlearn what I've learned, there's no way I can do it. Okay, never mind. I'll try.
No.
You don't want me to try?
Why not? Take it from the top. Do or do not. There is no try.
You are such a motivational speaker. You really are.
I do believe they think I am some sort of god. You can either talk in the crystal
ball. 51 penis diapers for $50 because that is the best deal. Frackin' earthquakes, man. Frackin' earthquakes. Frack you. Frack you. Frack you. You're cool. And frack you as well. How many of you like to eat at Chipotle? Well, if you really like Chipotle, this could be the thing for you. Chipotle's been around for 20 years. It's going to give 20 people 20 years of free burritos. Do you know how cool that is? 20 years of free burrito. Did you hear that? You may want to go ahead and get one of those adult diapers pretty soon. That's free meals until 2033. The dollar value, $9,100. Now, the promotion is called Adventurito. Adventurito. And beginning Sunday, the brand will debut a new Chipotle-related trivia question once a day for, you guessed it, 20 days at adventurito.com. Now, if you want to go there and check it out, that's adventurito.com. Participants will be entered to win free burritos for a year, and a select few with the highest trivia scores will be in the running for the grand prize. And that's the 20 years of free burritos. Now, of course, those lucky winners are going to have to consider maybe mixing up the next 20 years of their diet with salads, maybe some vegetables, some smoothies, things like that for all their other meals. I mean, unless in 2033 you want to finish the year at the cardiologist's office, because that could happen if you're not careful. You gotta love. I mean, that's a great idea. I mean, I think more places, because that's going to get them a lot of publicity. I mean, I've heard of places giving away free stuff for a year, but 20 years? Holy crap, man. That's crazy. Now, you think that some hospitals in America are bad. Wait till you hear this. This is freaking ridiculous. All right. An average annual income of $150. That's $150 a year. An average annual income of $150 a year. I was making more than that in 2 days when I was 12. Now, Zimbabwe is one of Africa's poorest countries, which makes it only that much more shocking that a local hospital would charge mothers-to-be $5. $5 is a lot of money when you make $150 a year. In Zimbabwe, if you did nothing else, you could afford to go to the movies with one other person, maybe three times. If both of you team up, you could go to the movies six times, but then you couldn't eat or do anything else for the rest of the year. Now, according to a new... let me tell you what they're charging them first. Charging mothers-to-be $5 every time they screamed during childbirth. Whoa. What? The hospital... Let me repeat this. They would charge mothers-to-be $5 every time they screamed during childbirth. Who's going to complain about living in America now? Do you want to complain a little bit? Move to Zimbabwe. Okay, maybe you'll be happier. Move to Zimbabwe. Raise your family of 10. I hate America. I'm going to get away from America. Let's go to Zimbabwe. It's so much better there. Now, according to a new report on corruption around the world, Zimbabwean hospitals also charge a $50 child delivery fee. So there's one-third, that's one-third of your annual income, the child delivery fee. God forbid you scream a few times. That could be well over half of your yearly income, just giving birth. And women who can't afford it, right, so if you cannot afford the scream tax and the $50 child delivery fee, you're detained with interest until your families pay up. So how many of these poor women do you think are being detained right now, right after their child was born, can't see their child, I don't know how much the fee is, but if they're charging them $5 for screaming, then I can only imagine. And listen to this. Perhaps unsurprisingly, 8 women die every day giving birth at home because they can't afford the hospital charges. Now, if you're out there and you're listening and you want some sort of a cause to fight for, why don't you stop hugging trees? Why don't you leave people alone that drive SUVs? Why don't you forget about global warming, global cooling, climate change? Why don't you forget about that shit and fight for stuff like this? Because this is real, and this is happening right now. If you want to fight for something, fight for this. Zimbabwe's deputy prime minister was contacted about the screaming fee, and complaints about the charge reportedly stopped. But the $50 delivery fee actually remains. Can you believe that? Can you believe that? See, that kind of stuff irritates me. So like I said, if you want something to stand up for something like that. Stop being a wuss and being an activist and following the crowd and all this crap. And do something like, you know, like that. That freaking shocked me when I came across that article. All right. Let me wipe off my serious face for a moment. Have you ever purchased an old piece of furniture from a friend? Now listen up, Sarah, because you do this kind of stuff all the time. Now imagine this. Imagine that the piece of furniture that you bought is actually a Japanese antique. I'm not going to tell you how much it's worth yet. And this is what happened to the owner of the chest. Now, the woman inherited it from her father. And remember the price that he paid for it. He'd purchased it from a Polish doctor in 1970 for about $150. Now, he used it after he purchased it for $150. He used it for years as a TV stand and a liquor cabinet. Now, the woman called an appraiser. Remember, he spent $150 on this Japanese antique chest. All right? When the woman called an appraiser to value her late father's possessions, he really didn't find much of anything that was of interest. But then she offered him a little sherry from Daddy's bar, which was the chest. Now, as soon as this dude saw the chest, he identified the piece. See, this kind of stuff would never happen to me. I'd have to go out and buy used furniture, I guess, for it to happen. But still, he identified it as a 370-year-old box made of cedar. And it has been purchased by a museum in Amsterdam for $9.5 million. Oh, could you imagine? Could you freaking imagine? Yeah, I bought this chest for $150. It's worth how much? Oh, frack me. Are you fracking kidding me? It's a good thing I had on some fracking adult diapers, because I just frackin' shite myself. One minute you've got a fairly expensive television stand, but not really, because you split it up and made a liquor cabinet out of it as well, because you know, $150. So basically you got $75 into a TV stand and then $75 into a liquor stand. But then, all of a sudden, you find out it's worth $9.5 million. How much would that change your life? Holy crap. I'd like to welcome Clinton to the chat. He says, oh great, that dang dork is on. How can I do a live show when that bloody dork is polluting the airwaves of Spreaker? Oh, hi, Chris. Just dropped in for a minute. My favorite TV show is on, so I'll be back in 30. I know that you will put a great show on as usual. And thank you, Clinton, so much. And Clinton is actually that poetry guy. For the love of poetry and spoken word. That's Clinton. That's his show in a nutshell. But now, seriously, if you aren't into poetry, you can listen to his show, and it'll actually turn you on to it because he goes about it in a really fun way. So make sure you check out For the Love of Poetry and Spoken Word here on Spreaker.com. Now, I was going to talk about something else, too. Hang on a second. Do you remember that kid that from Facebook who actually he said something that he shouldn't have said, and then he kept put in jail? Well, I think this is a little harsh, and this is just me, but let me kind of tell you what's going on in case you missed it. Justin Carter, he's been in a Texas jail since he was arrested for a horrible Facebook comment. And really, it was a very, very distasteful comment. Really was. But he's a 19-year-old kid. When I was 19, I was pretty stupid. I really was. I probably said some really dumb things. All right? But I don't know that the kid should have been thrown in jail for this. Now, he's been bailed out by an anonymous individual. Carter's father said a good Samaritan paid the 19-year-old $500,000 bond, which his family couldn't afford to pay. Now, Carter was charged with making a terroristic threat. And this, remember, this is a 19-year-old kid. After commenting he'd shoot up a kindergarten. And that is very distasteful. Maybe throw him in the clink for a couple of days. You know, say, hey, look, you shouldn't say stuff like that. You know, especially with all this stuff that's going on in the world. And he said this during a Facebook argument with a fellow gamer and had been in jail since March. Now, Carter wrote LOL and joking after the offensive comment, which his father says shows his son was joking. Carter actually faces 8 years in prison if he's convicted of the charge. And hopefully they're just trying to scare the kid because, I mean, is it just me or do you think that's a little too much? I mean, for a kid, I don't know. I maybe it's just me, but I think it could be just a little too much. Now, you know, the government's sneaky. The government's insanely sneaky, and you know that. But did you know that when the government looks into your phone usage, like your text, I guess, your voicemails and things like that, AT&T, Cricket, U.S. Cellular, Verizon, they don't just give over the information to the Uncle Sam, they actually charge them for it. And this is probably another reason our taxes are so high. So it's a pretty good racket that the phone companies have here. Now, AT&T actually charges the government $325 for an activation fee for each wiretap. I wish I could charge the government for something. And then they turn around and charge them $10 a day to maintain it. Now, you've got your smaller carriers like Cricket and U.S. Cellular. They're a bargain because it only costs $250 per wiretap. Isn't this making you feel safe? Well, it's going to get worse. Now, Verizon, on the other hand, is making an absolute killing. It charges Uncle Sam $775 for the first month of a wiretap. $775 for a wiretap. So maybe next time our taxes go up, we should call Verizon and say, what the frap are you doing? You frappin' frapper? So they charge them $775 for the first month of a wiretap, which they considerably drop to $500 a month after that. So they give them a $275 break if they continue to wiretap. Now, you've got Yahoo and Google. They're not going to say how much they charge for email records. But get this. The ACLU found that emails can change hands for as little as $25. $25. Uncle Sam could be looking at every single email that you've ever sent, that you've ever read. Isn't that scary? Is that not... See, this is... We need to start reading the fine print. You know how when you sign up for email accounts or your phone, and it's like you sign all this stuff, then you read this agreement? You don't read the agreement. You just check the box, and then you move on. So I guess that's what makes it legal for Uncle Sam to come in here and purchase your crap. That's scary, isn't it? I'd like to welcome Vic Miller to the chat. He says, yay, Chris Topp is back. How long have you been gone? And he says, Chris Topp is a radio god. Vic Miller, I will not argue with that. You're absolutely correct. Now, it's time, ladies and gentlemen, to spread that Spreaker love. And if you know what if you ever listen to my show, you know what I mean. If you're in the chat, and okay, now let me explain this. I'm actually talking to people. I'm not talking to the voices in my head. Contrary to popular belief, if you're listening on Spreaker, there's a live chat, and you can actually communicate with me while I broadcast. So if you're listening somewhere else, that's great. I'm glad you're listening, but you really should come on over to Spreaker because I'm on 30 different sites. So come on over to Spreaker. You can sign up. It's fun. It's easy. It's free. And you can join me in the chat while I broadcast, and you can talk to me directly. Now, you can leave comments and stuff on Facebook, but I don't check that continuously throughout the show. The chat's just kind of in my face. So it makes it a little easier for me to pay attention to. And I do want to say hello to Destiny. She left a comment on Facebook. And by all means, my Twitter's always wide open, so if you want to communicate with me via Twitter, that's fine too. But the best way to get through to the top is on Spreaker.com, and you can join the chat. Now, if you're in the chat and you have a show on Spreaker, make sure you type the word show into the chat, and then everybody else, I want you to click on them and at least listen to one of their shows, maybe follow them. If you don't like the show, then you can unfollow them. It's easy. But you may just find something that's pretty super cool. And I can say super cool because I'm a dork.
We're just here to spread that love all around. Spread it around. Spread it around.
What men are thinking.
What? Of course I love you. Come on.
I'll tell you anything to get what I want.
No, those pants don't make your butt look big.
Holy crap. I bet when you walk backwards, that thing beeps.
Of course you're the only girl I ever want.
Along with your sister and that best friend of yours from Brazil.
No, honey. Nothing will ever come between us.
Except maybe a cold beer and a football game.
Oh,
maybe even a warm beer.
This has been What Men Are Thinking.
Hello, dorks of the world, and wabba to all. That zombie apocalypse is quickly approaching, kiddies. Right this minute is the best time to look for the closest dork safe house. Why don't we ask little emo Timmy where he's gonna go when the zombies come a-knockin'? Oh, wait, look at that zombie go, eating what few brains little emo Timmy had left in his head. Remember, be a dork, be proud, be hip, and wabba.
5 out of 5 DJs would agree that Chris Topp is a radio god.
As I sit here, I look down at this once great city, its past riddled with manipulation, deception, and lies. If you weren't so blinded by your own obsession, you'd see the true villain. The mirror doesn't lie. Take a good look, and you'll see everything you truly detest. The future uncertain with the exception of one small detail. I am here to stay, no matter what you throw at me, no matter what you do to me. I'll keep coming, and I'll keep coming. I am the Dork Knight.
Listening to the Chris Topp program burns more calories than setting a fat kid on fire.
And that's right, my friends. You are absolutely, positively in the right place. This is the Chris Topp program. And if you missed the beginning of the show today, we had some diaper talk. We had some frack and fracked up talk. And I started the show with my old intro, and I forgot the drum roll, so I had to go back and play that. So you missed some fun stuff if you just tuned in. And today, like I said, it's a quick show just because I should be sleeping. But the problem is I'm addicted to this. And maybe that's the wrong word, or maybe it's the right word. I don't know. I love broadcasting and I love hanging out with you guys. I like spending time with you, and I don't know. This makes me feel good. This is therapy for me. So, with that being said, I do have to go. I have to get some kind of sleep. But I do totally appreciate all of you for listening. Those of you that are in the chat, those of you that are listening other places around the world, those of you that go back and listen to the podcast after it hits the archives, thank you. I do not, nor will I ever, take any of you for granted. There are a million other things you could be doing, but you chose to listen to me. That makes me feel pretty damn good. Sarah said she's leaving right now so she can go set a fat kid on fire. And if you haven't set a fat kid on fire today, then there's no time like the present. Until I broadcast again, please remember this. Life is good, and I'm gone.
Is it over yet?
Completely over.
You have been exposed to the Chris Top Program.
Yeah, okay, are we done? I really gotta get a life.
Warning. The person attempting to call you is only seeking phone sex. Please remember, phone sex is the leading cause of hearing aids in America.
You know, if you listen to the show at all, then you know I never leave after the outro. I always come back. It's like an encore. See, the reason I do this, it makes me feel like a rock star because I know you're doing it. I know everybody that's listening is there saying more. Chris, give me, and see, so I come back and I do this just for you. I do this just for you because I love you. And I'm going to talk just a little bit more because I am Chris Topp, the radio god, according to my buddy Vic in the chat. And I think I've probably said it a few times. But see, I'm not conceited. I promise I'm not. I just love what I do. Now, I would like to welcome Ashley to the chat. Now, Ashley, I have to tell you. If this is your first time in the chat, and I do believe it is. Scooter, why did you take off your pants? Nobody wants to see that. Put your pants back on. Ashley, if this is your first time in the chat, I have a mission for you. Now, don't be afraid. It's okay. Now, Vic, I'm not sure if you've done this either. Now, Vic, listen up. Vic and Ashley. If you've never done this, then you have to. You have to step from the closet and embrace the light of your dorkhood. And I'm going to tell you how in just a second. But see, this is kind of a safe haven for dorks. And if you're not ready to take that step, well, it's fine. You can still listen to the program. I mean, we welcome everybody. I promise it's not a cult. I know it sounds like a cult. I know that. Well, you can do it again, Vic. It's fine. And maybe that'll make Ash a little more comfortable with it. But you have to go to my Facebook fan page. And I'll get you the link, and I'll post it in the chat for you, because I'm super cool like that. I'm going to post the link. See, 2 years ago, that doesn't even count anymore. So you have to do that again, Vic. You have to post the dorkiest picture that you have of yourself on the Facebook fan page. Now, once you do that, you're free. You're free to be as dorky as you want. You are. See, it's time. It's time to go in and take our milk money back. You know, I'm sick of the mean girls always taking my milk money, so now it's time to just jump in there and finally get the milk money back. And see, this will put you in the Dork Hall of Fame with some of the other greats, like myself. Now, I'm going to talk about one more thing, and then if you can get your dorky picture in there before I go off of the air, and this time it'll be for good. Well, not for good. I'll be back in a couple of days, probably. But then I'll talk about it. Oh, man, see, my week is going to be jacked up. Next week, it's going to be jacked up. Because I've got a meeting that I have to go to. I'm going to be out of town for 3 days. I'm going to be out of town on my birthday. Not like I had any plans anyway, right? So I'm going to be out of town for 3 days in a meeting. It's a 3-day meeting. How much fun is that going to be? So I'm not sure if I can broadcast on location where I'm at. Probably not, because I'm not going to take all my stuff with me. So, I mean, that's going to be 3 days that I can't broadcast. So I don't know how I'm going to work it next week. I'm going to try. I'm sure I'll find a way. I should be sleeping right now, but I'm sure I'll find a way. But anyway, let's move on with the show. Another study. And see, I don't get this stuff. I really don't get this stuff. Ashley says we don't want to see that. Of course we do. We want to see your dorky picture. Oh, and Sarah, see, Sarah's got a good question. All right, now I need somebody. If you're listening to my program and you want to help me out, I need somebody to kind of come in and check out Abby. Well, Abby's my cat. See, I was going to ask my daughter to come in and maybe feed her, give her some water, change the litter box, that kind of thing. But now, then I found out my daughter is actually going to be out of town as well at the same time I'm gone. She's going to be on the beach, so she's going to be having more fun. So if you would like to help Abby, get in touch with me after the show. And we'll make that happen. I'll give you like $20, maybe, but I've trained Abby to actually take $20 from you when you come in. But not probably what I'll end up doing. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I could put a lot of food out and a lot of water. I mean, really, it's going to be like 2.5 days. It's not going to be 3 full days, so I don't know. See, I don't know my neighbors. I don't make a lot of eye contact with my neighbors. And the reason I do this, I just don't want people showing up all the time. I don't want people like knocking on my door. Hey, Chris, you home? Hey, I just want to come visit. I don't want that. I love my free time. I love my privacy. So that's why I don't make a whole lot of eye contact. So it's not like I can just say, hey, neighbor, you want to come up? So I got to figure something out. I mean, maybe my son can help me out. I don't know. But I'm going to try to figure something out. So I'm not going to have Abby put down Scooter. That's a little drastic. Ashley says she's not going to post her dorky picture. That's disheartening. See, I know you're probably a little nervous, and that's okay. I mean, a lot of dorks that haven't quite come out of the closet yet are a little bit nervous. And maybe you'll come around to it. Maybe you'll do it after the show. Now, here's another study that we could have done without, because I could have told you this. You could have given me half the money that you spent on this study, and I would have been cool with it. There's yet another essential component to our lives that's making us unhealthy. Can you guess what it is? Can you guess what it is? I'm going to get sidetracked real quick. You know, guys, how you've been taking those omega-3 fish oils to help with your heart? Well, now they're saying that could cause prostate cancer. So now you've got some serious thinking to do. Do I want to mess with my prostate or do I want to mess with my heart? I don't know. It just seems like a lose-lose situation. You could probably keep taking them or stop, and you're probably going to be just as fine. My two cents. Anyway, researchers at Kent State University, they discovered a link between prolonged smartphone use and poor fitness in college students. I really wish I had that suspense music to play right now because I know everyone is shocked over that. Now, even though a cell phone is much more portable than, say, a 40-inch HDTV, that small glowing screen is still contributing to a very lazy lifestyle. Now, those who use their smartphones to an excessive degree, some as long as 14 hours per day. Are you one of those people? Are you one of those people that uses their smartphone 14 hours a day? I hope you're not. But anyway, those people are less fit than those who averaged a little more than 90 minutes a day. Duh. Frackin' duh. I think if you do any frackin' thing for 14 frackin' hours, you're gonna get frackin' fat. That's what I think. Now, the study is said to be the first link to smartphone use and health. Seriously, dude. I could have told you that. I could have told you that in 5 minutes. Really, I could have. And you could have saved a bunch of money. Any activity that you do for 14 hours a day is probably not going to be healthy. And again, that's my 2 cents. Take it for what it's worth. Ashley said she's searching for her dorky picture. See, now when somebody says I have to search for my dorky picture, it kind of makes me wonder if they're a dork. Because in my case, I could pretty much put up any picture. I can put up any picture at all, and it's going to be dorky. So when somebody says they got to search for it, I don't know. I mean, maybe. But see, you can be a dork. I mean, we've proven time and time again on the program that you can be a dork and be a hottie. And we proved that on the show. We really did. It's very possible to be a dork hottie. So maybe you are, maybe you aren't. I'm just saying. Sarah says, not sure, Chris. If you work out 14 hours, you will not be fat. Well, I don't think it's probably very healthy to work out for 14 hours. I mean, your body needs rest to sleep for four. I mean, is there anything that you can do for 14 hours that's going to be healthy? I can't think. Can anybody think of anything? I'd like to know. If you can think of anything that you can do for 14 hours and it's healthy, please post that on my Facebook page. Well, I do have to go now. I really do. And like I said, I love you guys. I can't thank you enough for listening. And I will be back as soon as I possibly can. I promise. I'm hoping I'll get to come back and do another broadcast before I go to my super exciting meeting that I'm really looking forward to. See, I'm not even going anywhere really cool. It's about an hour and a half away from here. It's in Smyrna. I don't really want to spend 3 days in Smyrna. I really don't. And going to these meetings, I'm really, 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 really not excited about it. I'm really not. But anyway, I've got to go. Maybe I could take Abby with me. She could like go into. I could disguise her, possibly, and take her into the actual meetings with me. It's a possibility. That's something I could look into. So until I broadcast again, please remember this. All right. All right, hang on. Before I go, Ashley says her picture's posted, and she brings up a very good point. You could smile for 14 hours, and maybe that's good. See, that's a really good point. But if you're smiling for 14 hours, then maybe you're not getting any sleep in there. Well, I guess 14 hours, that still leaves you 10 hours of sleep. Would that hurt your face after? I don't know. That could be a good point. I'll have to look into that. I highly doubt smiling for 14 hours would cause cancer. So I don't know. So let's go take a look at Ashley's dorky picture. And there she is. She's proven once again that you can be a dork. And you can be a hottie dork as well. And she says she's a drunk dork. What is that shirt? Is that a Batman shirt that you've got on? Because if it is, that kind of makes you a really cool dork. I'm just saying. But Ashley is in the Dork Hall of Fame. And I'm hoping you're not regretting it now. But thank you so much for playing along. And I hope you come back and listen to the show again. I love picking up regular listeners. I really, really do. And Vic, what are you doing? Dude, you didn't post your dorky picture. You can, if you'll do it after the show, then I'll talk about it next time. So we'll see if Vic does that. But thank you guys so much. Until I broadcast again, please remember, life is good and I am gone.
I am the one and only Chris Topp, self-proclaimed leader of all dorks.
I'm Chris Topp, king of the dorks. That's right.
Yeah, I remember growing up when I was a little kid. My mom was so sweet. She would say things like, "Thank God, Chris, there's only one of you because you are so, so very special."
There is only one Easter Bunny. There's only one Jesus Christ. There's only one God. And there's only one Chris Topp.
I am the one and only Chris Topp, broadcasting live from my lavish studio apartment here in sunny Clarksville, Tennessee, with an ocean view.
Actually, that's not true. I live next to a dumpster.
Meow! Shut up, Abby. Keep quiet. Yes, I know. I don't really have an ocean view. I have a view of the local hobo singing around a burning dumpster, but I don't want my fans to know that.
Does Chris Topp have a mysterious side, a darker side, if you will? Well, I guess I do. You could compare my life to the Da Vinci Code.
C for Chris Topp. H for holy mackerel, it's Chris Topp.
Well, I don't know if my show would make sense if he played it backwards, but I do have a few things right in front of your face.
R for really awesome, Chris Topp. I for I can't believe, it's Chris Topp. S for somebody pinch me, it's Chris Topp.
Am I conceited? Am I conceited? No, I'm not.
D for terrific, Chris Topp. O as in oh my god, it's Chris Topp. And P for party time with me, Chris Topp.
God. Well, the ladies do like their Chris Topp.
God. Well, that's it for today, folks. I'll see you tomorrow. Until then, life is good.
And I'm gone.
Okay, I know I said I wasn't going to come back for the third time. I know I said I wasn't going to come back for the third time, but there's a very, very special person in the chat. A very special young woman that I love very much, and I'm probably embarrassing the crap out of her. But no, I haven't left, and I hope you're still here because I want you to hear this. I'm proud of this young lady, and I'm going to tell the world that right now because... And I'm going to have to leave again for the third time, I know. But I'm very proud of this young lady. I'm talking about my daughter, Ashley. She just recently turned 18, and she's about to start college. And we actually had a discussion last night on the phone. I can't believe how quickly she's grown up. I mean, I remember it was just like yesterday. She was born, and I thought, man, it's going to be forever before she's off to college. And then, bam, here it is. Just like that. Just like 18 years later, and she's going to school. And see, I think the same thing about being a grandfather. And don't, please, Ashley, don't rush that, okay? I don't want you to rush that one. I really don't. But my daughter, she's smart as a tack. She's smarter than I ever was. And she's got a good head on her shoulders, and she's got a great plan. So I just wanted to tell you, Ashley, that I'm very, very proud of you, and I love you very much. And it means a lot to me that you stopped by and came into the show. This is a very, very proud dad. With good reason. All right. I'm gone.
One man, one dream.
Dorks unite.
No, it's dorks of the world.
Dorks of the world unite.
Nice. The most sane radio personality on Spreaker.com.
Because I'm losing my mind.
No, you're being ridiculous.
I'm positively losing my mind. You made an F and you suck, little Timmy.
Because if you don't know how to lose, you don't know how good it feels to actually win.
Only streaking where no man has stroke before.
No, dude, it's not going to hurt their feelings, and if it does hurt their feelings, they need to grab their ball.
Okay, now I want you to take a deep breath first.
I feel giddy like a schoolgirl.
Not afraid to be controversial.
I'd like to welcome Yo-Yo Dino to the chat. Yeah, I gotta say, Dino, that was really gripping.
The one and only Chris Top, only on Spreaker.com.
Yeah, I've really gotta get a life.